What is a parameter in Tableau? I'm going to take the next 5-10 minutes to give you some examples of what parameters are in Tableau and what they can be used for. Let's go take a look in Tableau Desktop. Now that we're in Tableau Desktop, let's take a look at parameters, how to create them, and what they are. I'm going to open a new sheet here for a blank canvas. I'm going to click the drop down here to create a new parameter. I'll click the drop down in the data pane and create new parameter. We'll give you kind of a blank slate. I have a couple options here. I can choose float data types, integer data types, string, boolean, date time, and there's a couple other adjustments that you can make. Just to show you what a parameter is, we're going to start with an integer. The current value is going to be 1. I'm just going to call it integer value. Click OK. And you'll see that my new parameter called integer value shows up on the parameters pane. I'm just going to click the drop down on that integer value parameter and click show parameter. At its very simplest, a parameter is simply a user input into Tableau to make a change to something in the view. I can now change this integer value from 1 to 2 or 22 or 25. Nothing happens. Parameters in Tableau don't do anything until you connect them via a calculated field. So we're going to do two examples, one example with a string parameter and one example with an integer parameter. The integer value is already there, so let's start with that. I'm just going to grab a field here. I'm going to grab sales. I'm going to drag it onto rows. Measures always aggregate when they're drug into the canvas. So I'm going to change it from some, just to display a point here. I'm going to change it to a dimension and change it to discrete. So now I have every possible sales value in the data set. Goes from 0.44 all the way up to values of 22,000. Now let's say I wanted to filter this in some way. I wanted only to show sales above a certain amount. I could create a calculated field and reference my new parameter. Create a calculated field by clicking the drop-down on your data pane. Create calculated field. And I'm just going to simply write a yes or no, a true or false statement that tests if sales, and I can just drag sales from the view into my calculated field. I'm going to test if sales is greater than or equal to my integer value. You can see sales, you've probably used calculated fields before. Sales is orange, so all of your fields, your columns, are going to show up as orange. Parameters will show up as purple. So I'm just doing a true or false. I'm just going to call it sales is greater than parameter. Again, true or false, yes or no. I'm going to click apply. And I'm just going to drag that new field that I created onto color. It gave me blue squares for any value that is lower than 25, and orange squares for any value that is over 25. This is, of course, adjustable, because that's the point of a parameter, that you want the user to be able to change something about the view. I could change this to maybe 100. And you'll see that anything below 100 is now blue. Anything above 100 is orange. Of course, I could use this as a filter as well. And I can keep only true values. apply, okay, and you'll see that my whole view was filtered dynamically based on the parameter selector to show only values over 100. Alright, let's do a second example with string values instead of integer values. I'm going to create a calculated field by searching for region. I'm going to create a string parameter based on the region field. Remember last time I just clicked the dropdown and selected create parameter. This is going to be a second way to be able to create a parameter. And click on region, click the dropdown, select create parameter. This time, my list of values have been filled in for me. I didn't have to put a list in here myself. Tableau just put every unique region as a value in the parameter and just called it region parameter 2. We've got east, central, south, and west. Click OK. You see my region parameter showed up down here. Click the drop down. Click Show Parameter, and I have my my region parameter on the right-hand side here. Remember, parameters don't do anything until they're connected to the view. If I change this from east to north to south, nothing happens. I'm going to show you a pretty cool use case on using string parameters, a little different than the integer example. I'm going to create a calculated field. And I'm just going to call it chosen region sales. And I'm going to write a statement, just an if statement that says if region, and remember if it's orange, that means you are referencing a column. If it's purple, you are referencing a parameter. So if region equals region parameter, then give me sales. And if statements always end with an end. I'll click apply. And okay. So if I just move that region sales field that I just created onto text, I have 391,000. If I change region parameter to north, I get 501. If I move it to west or south, you know, I get the corresponding value. That's one way that you can use a parameter to adjust what's happening on your view. As a secondary example on this string parameter section, I can divide that. I can adjust this and I can divide my sum of the chosen region sales divided by just sum of sales. And that, if you're following along, is just percent of total. Click apply and OK. And if I grab that percent of total calculation, put it on text as well, and make this a percent format as a percentage, I can see that the south region has 391,000 in sales, which represents 17% of the whole. And of course, if I keep changing that, I get different values. So, you know, in short, parameters are used as a user entry to change something on the view.